All right, the courier's moving the plate from the docks today. I'm gonna go intercept them, grab the plates, lose any heat, and make my way back here. Now, depending how well this goes, we may have 5 minutes to print the money before the counterfeit syndicate finds us, or we may have all year. Either way, I want green rolling off the presses 5 minutes after I get back. Got it?
Don't you worry, Tommy. We'll be ready.
Me and the boys will be around in the neighborhood in case you need any heat taken care of.
All right, everybody cool? All right, I'll catch you later.
That will not only help you unleash the Furies, but unleash yourself. It's in my Thor's horsepower program.
Okay, I'm a little confused. Well, I'm a lot confused. I was taught in school that Vikings were bloodthirsty and violent.
An elder once told me, you must unlearn what you have learned. Of course, then he died of the green thing. There are some Vikings that are a bloodthirsty lot, yes, but no more than anyone else, really. We're a nomadic people, Amy. We have cold fire in our souls. We have that fire too, Amy. You've just lost it since you've gotten television. Now, that being said, I'll answer your question. We are mostly non-violent, though many of the Vikings travel to Scotland. And mind you, anyone who goes there will turn bloodthirsty. You can't understand what the lot are saying. It's all a poor, reckless, a boot, in a. It's enough to make you want to burn a village to the ground. That's why, in my cassette series, I talk about the importance of communication. You see, Amy, men and women live in different worlds. We use different words. A group of men talk about what they've killed, how to start a fire, who has the best long boat. Women want to talk about keeping it feet along, untidy, and their feelings. When I'm raiding a village, I don't need to be talking about feelings. It's time for action.
Right. So is that all there is to being a Viking? Pillaging?
No, lass, no. Pillaging and battle are important, but we admire poetry as well. As long as it's posed about whacking someone in with a double-handed battle axe. What's holding you back, Amy? Chapter 3 of my book, I talk about listening to the bloodthirsty water spirit. It's really quite important.
I think I went there last night. Oh, no. That was Malik.
Excuse me. What was
you're not welcome. Kill him.
Get the plate!
The Sunkless, 10-71, center up, light mode.
Shaving, you know? Down in the pit of your soul, you wish you could crouch in the grass, eyes biting your face, afraid to move for fear of alerting the beasts, covering yourself with yak urine to thwart the spell. Then, a beast draws close. You bounce, bringing your battle axe on its skull. Man and animal at that moment, one in the sand in its terrible beauty. Then you drag the carcass back to the top and celebrate by eating its mark. Some people may overdo this.
Girls are out.